Alan Hanel. Kelly, you're my very best friend. You're amazing. Kimmy, you know I feel the same way about you. I will always love you. I mean it. You know, yesterday, Bridget gave me one of her school photos. One of the little Wallace-sized ones. And she wrote on the back of it, best friends forever. But she doesn't mean it. She was just writing that.
She wrote that on mine too.
No way.
Yes way.
See, that's what I mean. Some friends go around writing that stuff and saying that stuff to everybody, but they don't mean it. But when I say it to you, and when I write it on the back of the 8x10 school photo I always give you, you know I really mean it. Kimmy and Kelly, best friends always, forever and ever.
Amen.
See, that shows exactly how amazing of friends we are when we finish
each other's sentences.
Exactly. It's like we're one person inside two bodies.
I know. I mean, sometimes when I'm talking to you, I feel as if I'm just talking to myself.
I know what you mean. And how many times have we worn practically the exact same thing? And we didn't even call each other.
I know. We have the same taste in food, the same taste in music,
same taste in fashion, same taste in guys.
Yeah, we do, don't we?
We are the luckiest two people on earth to have each other as friends. The first day in kindergarten, the first day I met you, it was like a cloud just opened up, and the sun came shining through, and I knew we were going to be like twins.
Yeah, I remember that.
We both had Powerpuff Girl coloring books. But what color was it that we both had missing from our crayon sets?
Yellow.
Yellow! That was amazing!
We both came in with the exact same color missing.
Fate, destiny,
true,
true friendship.
We're going to the same college, aren't we?
You better believe it.
We'll both major in psychology,
and we'll graduate together and become famous psychologists.
We'll call ourselves Kimmy and Kelly,
best friend psychology!
I like that. That's perfect.
You're perfect, Kelly.
So are you, Kimmy.
But you know what, Kelly?
What, Kimmy?
If I ever catch you flirting with Marco again, all of that stuff won't be anything.
What?
You know what I mean.
Hey, if anybody was flirting with anybody, he was flirting with me. Can I help it if he happens to find me attractive?
Why he'd find fat cow attractive, I have no idea.
Well, maybe it's because you stuck with the bloated, self-centered witch.
Me? Self-centered? Look who's talking, it's drama queen.
Oh, look in the mirror, why don't you?
You make me sick.
Stay away from Mark.
Make me.
I hate you.
Oh, not as much as
you. Ow!
Let go!
Thank you.